people, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're doing fine. I hope you had an amazing weekend. Another week, this is another me, and this is another video of me. So if you haven't yet, please subscribe. It's free, full of adventure. I love fashion. I do give fashion advice twice a week, Tuesday and Thursday at 3 p.m. Eastern time every week. So I would love it for you to just join that community growing more and more and more. So welcome to my new subscribers, by the way, because I've had a lot more recently, and I hope you're not gonna be disappointed, but it's not my goal to actually disappoint you. So it's all gonna be my main trend favorite when it comes to spring 2018, and I'm so excited about it because in a couple of weeks we get into the official spring. Because of course in Canada it's not the same story as other countries. Spring is not at the end of March, it's more like somewhere after March, but you know, we've been used to it. But I'm still excited because I've seen a lot more colorful things in stores that I've showed you. Going any further, I do have Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and I do have my full official website, which is www.eatfreeandshop.com. I have a blog post as well, and on there you're gonna find a lot of services like I love to say all the time. Of course, are mainly for Montreal area or greater Montreal area, because it's like mostly mainly the island, but I'm available to talk and have any kind of fashion advice related question. My newest digital magazine lookbook, my outfit inspiration related, please check it out. It was a lot of like must-haves when it comes to what's going on for spring, what you need to get for spring, what kind of outfit inspiration you can have for spring. So everything is in there. I have a little bit of advice. It's not a big lookbook, but I think it's still something that would be good for any person out there that love fashion as much as I do and that needs kind of fashion advice. So I'm here for that. For this video, it was all about the spring trends 2018. So I'm not gonna go on all of the trends because there's more that I'm gonna say here. I'm gonna try to say like 5-6 trends that I really really love, that kind of trend that I'm really really drawn to. So I'm gonna talk about them here. And first, a trend that I would talk about is gonna be sweater. It's spring, so it's still cold, so you still need to have something warm, you still need to have something covered. Depending on the country where you're gonna live, sometimes you need to just double up. We're getting out of like winter, so it's not new. What's new, what I like about it, is that you have the chunkier, bigger sweater where you just feel like a baby. And I had some kind of celebrities look that I was looking for that would be a really good to inspire you as well. I found one, which is Marion Cotillard. I think this sweater honestly is the bomb. I think it's a so cute, it's a dress, a really short dress, so you really need to have that kind of like amazing legs to just wear it and rock it. That it's amazing, like creamy beige color, so it's a kind of sweater that you can wear with pretty much anything. I would say it's something that I would suggest you to have, that kind of color, because it's really the color for every type of, even every type of like skin tone. I would say it, most of the time it look good in you. The thing that I love about sweater is that it's not only chunky, but it's a really good basic when you want to style it with something either more dressy or more like laid back. I have both options, and I say that all the time. For me, the point is to be able to have like a couple of basics that I can play around with. Show you so many options just from one piece or two pieces. Spring, the trend is to have that kind of like colorful, warmer colors, the red sweaters, the mustard, the green, because the cream is a basic when it comes to like the color. But then for the spring, the current spring, I would say go for like warmer colors, green, like the pants that I have currently, the green, you can go with the red, you can go with the yellow, you can go with pretty much a lot of colors when it comes to spring. In a couple of months where everything was a little bit more grayish, if I could say it, it's definitely something that is trendy. The chunky, the bigger, the better. If you're short a little bit like me, if you go with something chunkier, don't go with like a really chunky dress sweater, because if you have like shorter legs, emphasize your shortness and you don't want that. So what you want is that to have something chunkier on the top, and then to just like play with the illusion to have like a really nice shape, go with something skinnier. A skinny jean, a skinny pants would go really nicely with something much chunkier, because it's gonna like emphasize the shape. The second trend that I'm gonna be talking about here is the patchwork. You have seen, or if you've been to Zara or H&M, actually more at Zara from what I've seen so far, you see much more like patchwork type of jackets, a little bit more like ethnic or tribal inspiration type of like jacket or dresses. Seen it more and more and more. And I have another picture from another celebrity, Jhené Aiko, and of course the whole outfit is really ethnic or tribal inspired. I really love that trend, because again, here you get to see stuff that you're not necessarily gonna see in fashion, but you kind of see it more and more now. To combine that kind of natural type of fabric is something much more trendy or much more like modern. And being African, being raised in African Cameroon, it's all the type of see that I used to have or used to see back when I was much younger. So I really love that kind of design, when you kind of get to combine all of type of texture and all of type of natural or handmade stuff. The tone this year is just something that I love. The third trend that I'm gonna be talking about here is sneakers. I've said it before, sneakers for me have always been that type of shoes that I would use to go to the gym or go to the sport, but I'll never ever wear them to just go out to have some coffee or to just go out with my friends. Never seen them like it. Here the trend is to be able to just mix match styles, hence the sneakers being on the trend. You are able to just have a really nice long dress, which could be something super flowy, something super summery, and then you twist the style altogether and have the sneakers instead of having a heel. Cool. And it's something that I wasn't used to like as much before. The problem that I've always had with sneakers is that most of the time I would find them too chunky, too big, not so much like refined. And to me, if I'm able to find some sneakers that I love, of course, it's because of a style. They have a kind of like more refined style. My best friends now, as far as sneakers, are these two. Like, so cute, because they have a really nice feminine detail here, although it's a sneaker. And then here, it's like much more detailed. They have a much more like embellishment. So it's a really nice one, because have a lot of colors that you can pick from and then mix match it with any outfit that you have or that you can think about, to be honest. I think I'm just gonna add more to the collection, but no comments. These sneakers are a really nice way to just like flat but be really stylish. Choose your sneakers like wisely, because for me it has to be simple or refined or has that kind of edgy touch to it. But other than that, if it's like too sportswear, it's something that I'm not gonna like as much. This is a really nice way of me seeing sneakers, and a suggestion that I would have for you is to maybe to try to mix it up with like something like leather or pleated. I think the above are so nice when it comes to it, because they are so different in terms of lifestyle. So if you have a leather pants or leather shirt like the one I showed you couple of videos before with sneakers, and then on top of that you have a pleated coat or pleated jacket, I would say you would kill it. One trend that I'm gonna be talking here is the sheer. Everything that is transparent, everything that you can actually see through a skirt, is coming back. We've had it at some point, but coming back for the spring. I've always loved it anyway, so that hasn't changed anything to what I love about them. Nothing. But I'm gonna have a picture here of Willow Smith. The way she actually paired it is so nice. I think I really love the whole outfit, because she had a really rocked it. An amazing way to just be stylish. And then again, that kind of skirt is something that again you can style with like sneakers. The anything for me with sneakers is just amazing.
The fifth brand that I'm gonna be talking about here is gonna be the trench.
Well, trench is something that you need to have for spring because it's much lighter, and of course it's just a basic piece again for me. What I love to see with trench is that we're trying to actually like use other texture to do it, and I love it even more. You kind of get to see some vinyl trench coats, leatherish texture, leatherish fabric, and some inspiration. Two inspiration from two celebrities. One is Bella Hadid. I think her trench is just gorgeous. And the second is like Kaia Gerber. Again, she rocked it. I love it. I love the texture. This is just what I love to see. The first step is to go with something much more basic, much more camel color in my head. But there's another trench that I actually saw at H&M that I loved a lot. It's orange. If I have a picture, I'm gonna like show you that here. I think it's just a perfect color for like spring. Reminds me of that kind of, it's another warm color, so of course I love it. The length is like pretty long. The rest, I love everything about this coat. I think I'm gonna get it probably soon, but not for now, but probably soon. If you have basic pieces, you either go with a trench that have that kind of bold colors to it, exactly like the H&M one. I think the bold color is just gonna add that kind of pop color if you have something much more basic. But if you have much more like statement type of pieces when it comes to like your under layers, go with a really basic trench coat if you're not sure, because I think you have to choose one of them. Either something much more like statement looking as the your under layer, or something much more like bold or statement as the top layer, which is gonna be the trend. For me, the art of layering is just to play with your visual. Play with the visual is all about the layering here. Last trend that I'm gonna talk about here is gonna be the suits and trousers and the way they are like that kind of like culottes trend again, because we've been having that last year if I remember and I recall that. I had it now, but so nice because it helps you to define your waist so much better. They are high waist, so if you have like shorter legs like me, the illusion that you actually have longer legs. Have something much more like high waisted, and if you have heels, of course you are able to play with that. You're able to give the illusion that you have longer legs that you in reality you have, and I love it. Whole suit, as in the whole suit with the same print, the same color, the total suit. I have an example which is the one from River Island that I actually showed you in my lookbook. The colors here were so nice because it's like pleated, it's gray, white and pink. It's just like fresh. But it's still modern, because what you want to avoid when it comes to having a suit which is the same color from head to toe is to have it a little bit in the like old fashioned type of way. What you want when it comes to like having the same color and having to do the matchy matchy type of look, you want to go with modern cut. Going with the matchy matchy is not gonna look old fashioned because you're gonna be able to know how to do. What makes it modern is the cut and is the pleats, which are two things that are really currently trend for spring. And because of that, even if it's like matchy matchy, it's still modern because it has a kind of modern touch to it. That was it for this video for the trend. I hope you liked it. I hope you kind of got some really nice inspiration based on everything that I've said, and that you actually got to have some advice based on what you're looking in terms of like what's going on with spring. I will see you this week on Thursday for another video, so stay tuned for that. Be ready and have yourself a wonderful beginning of the week, of course. Like I say all the time, smile because it's free. Bye.